Hey YouTube, it's Matt with Olympus Reptiles, and we are going to do another egg cutting today, filmed this time not by myself, but by Kirk. But before we do that, I got something really cool to tell you about. We are going to be cutting clutch number 30, and then we're going to turn around and cut clutch number 31. Then we're going to turn around and cut clutch number 32, so I really hope you like seeing these. But before we do that, we actually had a company reach out to us to partner with us, which is, I don't know, mind-boggling to me, but they did. And they wanted us to look at their product, and it was funny because this is a company I'd actually already been looking into for my own purposes. So we decided we were going to study them a little bit more. I did a whole bunch of research before I agreed to work with them to make sure that they were A, did what they said they were doing because it's a really cool mission, and B, had really good reviews, and C, took care of their customers when there was a problem, all of which they do. So then we agreed to work with them a little bit, and they sent us some product to look at, and I'm going to tell you about that now. It's a company called Fahlo. You'll find a link in our description, but Fahlo is spelled funny. It's like F-A-H-L-O, and if you get with this company, you're going to be the one doing the following. So what do you get to Fahlo? Well, it's pretty cool. You get this kind of neat little jewelry, kind of like, you know, surfer dude kind of stuff. I've got a couple of them. Mine has a lion on it and an elephant on it. And the cool thing is you open up your cell phone, because, well, I guess I should start here. If you do that, you're going to get, like, something like this. It'll look like this little card, tell you all about your lion. You're going to scan that QR code, and then you're going to get an app on your phone, right? Looks like right there, F-A-H-L-O, Fahlo. Touch that app. It's going to open up. Eventually, we have slow internet here, and you get the whole world. You can simply touch My Animals, look for the lion. You can view her story or her journey. Let's look at her journey. It will tell us everywhere our lion has been. That lion has gone a long way, y'all. So you get to kind of see everywhere it goes. It made a very long journey here. I mean, I'm going to have to learn why it would make such a long journey, because I didn't realize they would do that. You can zoom out and kind of see what part of the world your lion's in. Pinch, zoom, and go a little faster. So you can see right there, for those of you that aren't familiar with the map, that is a little spot in Africa, just south of the Middle East there. So really kind of a neat area, neat thing that you can watch. I can also layer my map and see different stuff on it. I can go basic if you don't want the satellite image and tell what country it's in. In this case, it's in Kenya. You could also do a, like, you know, satellite. You can do hybrid relief. You can do all kinds of stuff on there. So it's really cool information. You can also read about your lion, see his total distances traveled, you know, a little bit about it. So here's the cool part. This tracking is with Owosso lions. That's because I got a lion. If I look at my elephant, it's going to be different. If Kurt looks at his shark, it's going to be different. If Caleb looks at his polar bear, it's going to be different. But a chunk of the proceeds that you spend on these actually goes to organizations that are tracking these for research and to help them, like Save the Blue, the Turtle Conservatory, Owosso Lions. So you can feel good that your purchase, not only is it stylish, it's kind of fun. If you have kids, they're going to love it. My wife is so excited being an elementary school teacher about sharing this with her kids. You know that your money is going to a good cause. Now, I did tell you that obviously this company is working with us. You're thinking, yeah, of course you're going to say good things about this because you have a monetary gain. You'd be right. But you're really not. Because, well, if you use our link and our discount code, which is Olympus20, all lowercase, will save you 20%, yes, there is a kickback to us for working and doing this advertising a little bit, which we're going to constantly see us updating our animals. We're not keeping that money. We're going to take that money, since it's for animals already, and we're going to give it to our local zoo as part of a donation that we want to do every year. So the part that we make, we're going to turn right around and give it to a place that also helps locals and children find their love of animals here in Manhattan, Kansas. So please use our link and know that not a single dime goes to me if you don't like me. 10% is going to go to whatever organization you choose for your bracelet. Our 10% is going to go directly to the local zoo. It won't go instantaneously. We'll kind of collect all that, and then about a year later, we'll take it, give it all to them. So that's how it's going to work. Any questions, Kurt, about how we're going to do Fahlo?
No.
Caleb, any question how we're going to do Fahlo?
Nope.
I can also tell you, I am pleasantly surprised with the bracelet. I don't wear a lot of jewelry. I wear a wedding ring, and I wear a watch. That's it. I'm actually going to rock these things, even when I'm not on camera. They're pretty comfortable. They're pretty cool looking. I especially like the colors on my elephant one. It's just really neat. And we all have different animals, so we're going to share with you the journey of our animals as we go along.
I do have a question.
Kurt does have a question.
So yes. The bracelets come in different colors?
They do.
They didn't have purple?
They did not have purple. Fahlo, man, give me a purple one. You got to give me some purple. Not like a lavendery pinky purple like my phone here. Give me like a legit purple. I'm already getting crap about my phone case, but I like it. Screw the haters. But yeah, get us a nice solid purple. We'll definitely rock that. So let's get on to egg cutting. Now, another thing you see is going to pip because the clutch after these pip. And I don't even remember what the pairing is. Do you?
On this one?
30. I'm going to challenge you to go look. Sorry, buddy. I totally forgot. I think these are just hets.
Albino. Oh, yeah. It's the albino to the pine.
So here's the thing. We've got, and do we have 5 eggs on it originally? Can you look at that?
I forgot to look.
I got to talking about Fahlo. I was really excited about those coming in. I am honestly very excited about those bracelets like a kid, you know, because I just love things like that. We are going to cut this egg. I already lit a candle. This egg is probably going to smell terrible. The thing is, when in doubt, incubate it out. It hasn't molded. I think this egg is going to be dead. It looks dead to me. But there's also part of the egg that looks pretty good. So we're going to give it a shot and see what happens. These 4 I expect to be just fine. How many eggs do we have?
7 eggs, 1 slug.
7 eggs, 1 slug. So wouldn't surprise us because I told you later on in the year, we had a lot more egg loss than we had early on in the year. We had like none early on in the year. Here we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it appears we lost 2 of these throughout the time. And then, of course, we've got that one, which will probably be another loss. Come on, everybody, stay in there. Another reason why I like those light diffusers. Well, this is an old-looking light diffuser. Oh, man, this is going to be... You all should probably be glad you don't have smell-o-vision today. All right. So here goes nothing. What am I looking for here? Everything in this clutch should be, unless there's something we don't know about, double het exanthic pied. Albino pied. Double het albino pied. Super gooey. I will show you something really cool on the egg if you stick with me on this clutch before I cut it. I think I grabbed a new pair of scissors. Oh yeah, they cut great. These things aren't dulled up yet from lots of use. So there you can see in there. There is an egg in there, a snake in there. Let me cut a little more this direction. That thing is way down in there. And these are on like day 56. So they are definitely ready to go. But and that does look a little bit... Yeah, it looks a little strange. We're just seeing the belly, so I think it's right where we think it should be. Okay, there's some movement in there. That one looks to be okay. So what's kind of throwing me for a loop is we're looking at the underneath of that snake all the way through, which makes it a little bit hard to kind of see what's going on. I'm going to set this egg to the side. That egg's special. That's why I'm going to show you something really cool. And before we cut it, let's cut these other 2. When you get really full eggs like this, you just got to kind of make as thin of a snip as you can. At least that's how I do it. Some people use razors. Some people use gigantic scissors. Some people use all kinds of crap. I just like to make a little thin snip to get me started. And then start working through there. Come on, little buddy. So there's the head of that one. You're a cool looking little snake. You're moving a lot. It's got a really neat look to the what I think is a tail right there. It's interesting. And again, that's to be expected because you're playing with double hets here, right? Anytime you're using double hets, even single hets can get kind of weird looking or usually a little bit cleaner and nicer depending on what kind of head it is. The double hets will be funky sometimes just because there's a couple recessive genes in there playing around. You know what? We're going to just cut through that. We're going to make a bigger mess than I'm able to fix. So there we go. Ugh. Hey, got the flap out. That's what I was after. And again, this is like showing really good flaming. Looks really good in the egg. Good movement on that one. You're seeing the rest. Now, I promised if you stuck with me, because I'm going to cut that egg dead last, because that's probably going to be horrible. I want to show you on this one. There's a little window right there. And earlier, I don't know if you'll be able to see it now. There, you can see it. You can actually see the snake moving through that window. So these windows are just spots in the egg that's just a little bit different. Maybe didn't calcify fully. Sometimes they'll be a lot bigger than this. Small ones are kind of neat because there's not enough to worry about mold or any issues, and you can actually see movement through there and kind of tell the snake's doing okay. So I already know this snake, I don't need to jab it because I've already seen it move in the window, so I know it's alive. We're still going to cut it to give it an exit. But we do know that this snake is alive. And there you are. So I think it's exactly what we expected. I'm out of habit. I'm still poking it. Pokey, pokey. Which would be double het, 100% albino and pied. The reason for that is we want to work into some more recessive, double recessive projects. All right, boys. See, now Kurt's really smart. He decided the Zoom feature is a good idea. Caleb is ready for the bucket for us to take this thing and throw it to the outskirts of the world. I honestly probably shouldn't even cut this egg, but there's a lot of decent looking egg on there. So we're going to give it a shot. So right there, I can already tell you, we don't need to cut any further. You can see how that looks. That means there is nothing in there. That's just going to be turned to a kind of a goop with some liquid in there. I really don't want that liquid to spill inside here. We're going to set that there. If you want to go pitch that to the world. But if you're ever in doubt about an egg, ever, I'm a believer, when in doubt, incubate it out. And also, when in doubt, go ahead and cut it. Now, if you know beyond any shadow of a doubt that the egg is trash, don't. Unless you're just wanting to cut it for scientific purposes to see where it died and developed or how it looked inside. That thing, I was like 85 to 90% sure it was trash, but I wanted to take, you know, I don't want to take that 5 or 10% chance for something still surviving in there. And what kind of gave me the smallest ray of hope is you can see some of the shell was still white. It hadn't really molded. However, the color had turned in all, it just didn't look very good. But we got four that are 100% going to be double het. So what am I hoping to do with this? Excuse me. Well, I'm really hoping to hold back probably a female, recreate double hets again down the road, and then hold back a male and work for some albino pieds. They won't be lavender albino pied. I know there's a big push for lavender albino pied. Personally, lavender albino pieds are awesome, but if I was going to go for that coloration, I personally would probably go with Toffino. I just like the looks of the Toffino more than I do the lavender pie or lavender albino, and that's where I would probably go to get those colors. But we want to start with the straight albino pieds, so that's what we're working towards. Plus, we had extra albinos, and we want to start a project with them. Kurt, anything you want to add?
So you don't have any adults or any other snakes that are double-het albino pied?
No. Okay. Not that I can think of. We have albino head exanth, or possible head exanthic adults. We have adult double-het adult double het albino and exanthic. We also have a very young adult male visual albino and exanthic, but getting pied into those projects, this is a first. Truth be told, I could even breed the snow male to this and make snows, or they wouldn't be snows, they'd be albino het for snow, pos het for pied, and try to work where I could get some albino lightning pied. Triple recessive if I really wanted to go for the long game down the road. That's definitely in the mix. We wanted to do that. There's all kinds of options we could play with here. Any other questions?
No.
Caleb, you're back after a stinky egg. Any questions?
That was brutal.
Did you get a whiff in there?
Oh, it was brutal.
It spilled out?
It spilled out. Oh, it was awful.
Was it awful?
It was terrible. I left the whole bucket outside. I threw that thing and I left the bucket out.
I like my bucket. We're going to have to get
that. I will bring that back later.
That's awful. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. We make Caleb smell something worse than my farts today. And we will catch you all later. Remember to check out our Patreon. We're going to talk more about this. Also, check out our link, Olympus20, for the code for Fahlo. All right, guys. Thank you so much. We'll catch you next time.